Hi everyone, and welcome to this video explaining how I designed and built this ping pong table, and more importantly, how you can build your own. Because yes, all the plans are open source and we share everything for free. You can find the link in the description down below. This is a project that was meant to be done using a full format CNC machine, such as the Mekanika fab. But with some creativity, you should definitely be able to reproduce it using smaller machines and tools. So come with me and I will explain everything in this video. Originally, we wanted a table for a new office in Brussels, and it was funnier to build it ourselves. This means that some choices were made to match our needs and tools, and it also means that this video is the first try at building it, so there is room for improvement in the methods used. But that's the power of open source, you know, you can update the project and share your better version with the world anytime you want. First of all, here's all the required materials. You can pause the video if you want, but remember that all the info is available in the guide on our website. The files were prepared for an 8mm bit from Fraser, but if you use any other type of bit, you should definitely adjust all the cutting parameters in the original file to adapt them to your machine and your bit. This being said, I can now show you my setup of the machine. This is a Mekanika Fab CNC. I'm adding my 8mm bit and measuring it with the Z probe. I can go get my first panel. This is a full panel, 122 by 244 centimeters. I put it on the wasteboard. I load my G code for the first panel. And I can set the origin point in a corner. I'm checking manually that all the parts are fitting inside the panel. I want to make sure that there is no tool pass going outside of the panel. Once it's made, I can load my nail gun and fix the panel using composite nails that are not dangerous for the end mill. It's ready to cut, I add the dust shoe and launch the program. The first panel is cut. I can remove all the leftovers and gather my parts and put them on the side. Then I load the second panel. It's the same size, so I use the exact same setup and launch the second program. In this panel, there are tabs holding the smaller parts. I have to cut them all before gathering the parts. Once everything is removed, I take all the parts aside and put them with the rest and remove the leftover. I can now put the bigger panels. Those are made for the tabletops. They are cut to fit exactly my machine, and there is almost no space between the gantry and the panel. For this, I had to reduce the size of the official tables of a few centimeters. This way, I'm able to cut it on my machine. You have to cut two tabletops, they are identical. And once it's done, you can clean the CNC, we are done with it. we are not getting to the finishes. We need to sand everything, all the sides and all the edges to a 120 grit to make sure everything is smooth and avoid frictions. And then we need to start the pre-assembly. We start with the front fit. They are made of three parts. Make sure you check the plans because the parts have a direction. I temporarily put the crossbar inside to make sure everything is aligned. I clamp it. And I can screw it. Then for the inner articulations, they are simpler, made of two identical parts. The smaller round part is just a spacer, you don't really need to glue it now. Here I use some tubes to align the parts. Then I can clamp it and screw them together. Once everything is dry, I can round the corners of everything. It makes it look better and it's also good to avoid splinters while playing. I do this on all the other parts of the structures. Any edge that is visible needs to be rounded. Now we have to assemble the base of the structure. It is a very important part, so I add a lot of glue and a lot of screws. These parts need to be really solid. Then I can tilt it and add the wheels at the bottom. Before assembling, I did a varnish coat on all the structure parts because it will be hard to do it later. Then we can go to the tabletop. We'll need to align perfectly the two panels face to face and make sure they are in the same direction. Once it's done, I can take the piano hinge and fix it exactly in the middle. Note that I used a few 4mm spacers between the panels to make sure the barrel of the hinge has some space to move. And finally, I went to the hardware. I did cut some screws to the right size because they were overlapping a bit too much and I wanted them to be flush. I also did grind some of the tubes to the exact size of the joints. You can get all the dimensions in the online guide. I also added some holes in the crossbars, they will be used to put some screws to fix the tabletop later. And here are all the parts ready to be assembled. The first step is to fix the inner articulations with the spacer. All the joints in the design are fixed this way. It's a screw passing in a washer inside the steel tube and a washer and a lock nut on the other hand. They should not be tightened too much. They should allow rotation, but tight enough to avoid wiggling. Then I'm fixing the structure, starting with the arms. And then the front feet. Once the crossbars are fixed, you can add some screws inside to tighten everything and make sure it's all rigid and solid. For the next step, you might need some friendly hands because the tabletops are heavy. So I add some glues on all the top edges in preparation, and once it's done, I ask some help to put the folded tabletops on one side. Someone has to hold the other side because it's a bit wobbly. The tabletop is the key holding everything together, so until it is fixed, the structure is moving, remember it. I can now use the holes made in the crossbars to screw the tabletop. And after that, you can do your first test play. And we can also test a first folding of the table. And luckily everything went well on this first try. With all that done, I had an idea to make it look even better. So I chose to dye it with blue color, just like the professional table. When it's dry, I can do the final varnish on the tabletop. And voila, the table is over. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I really hope you will share with us your improvement on the model and how you build your own. I hope to see you soon. I say goodbye, and until next time. Bye.